My passion for construction materials developed when I grew up on the construction site of my parents' retirement home in Santa Fe. Every summer, my five sisters and I would build the adobe walls. I remember looking into the mortar mixer at the water, the straw, the dirt, the sand, mixing around on hot summer days. One day, we were building an adobe wall when a storm hit, so we all ran for shelter. A few minutes later, we realized that someone had forgotten a key ingredient in the last batch. So we quickly returned to the wall, and we found that the rain had washed it away into a puddle. The material had completely disintegrated, and we cried, and then we rebuilt the wall. A few years later, in high school, I traveled to India, and I saw workers rebuilding roads by hand. I met families that passed down construction practices that enabled them to repair historical structures annually with care. These experiences motivated me to study structural engineering. However, in undergraduate, I was introduced to a new perspective. I was taken to downtown Chicago to idolize the rows of concrete skyscrapers. I was introduced to buildings that were hard to maintain, and they carried an expectation of permanence. They were made with plastics and concretes that would never disintegrate. Their bonds could not be undone. To achieve this, we need to use manufacturing methods that release a lot of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. Now, what's great about concrete is today, we can design concrete to achieve whatever strength we pretty much might want. We can proportion the rock, the sand, binding cement paste to achieve targeted lifetimes. What this means is that if a municipality would like to design a road to last 5 years or 100 years, we can intentionally make that happen. Now, this raises a question. Should we further pursue this design concept that stronger is better? I don't think so. I think there's more value today in understanding how construction materials fall apart, how they disintegrate. Let me give you two specific examples. First, all the rescue workers that helped after 9/11 ended up developing respiratory health problems. We found concrete particles in their lungs. We could engineer concrete such that it fractures and falls apart in a way that we would not have similar health complications for a similar dynamic event or if an earthquake were to hit a large city. Let me give you another example. Today, we come up with compostable or recyclable alternatives to many consumer products that end up in landfills. Why not do the same in construction? If we know that the structures we are designing have targeted lifetimes, we could use materials that will disintegrate once we have reached those lifetimes. Now, some of you may have read some books or watched a movie in which we envision an abandoned city. Let's take Chicago with its elevated concrete roads. We have this vision that the concrete, when abandoned, will start to crack and plants might grow through those cracks and nature will reclaim the city. This is not how I see it. Today, when we have an abandoned concrete structure, we cut it apart and we put it in a landfill. The cities that we abandon will turn into landfills. Landfills covering this earth. My research aims to better understand the disintegration of construction materials and concrete. I would like to enable a full cycle of creation of new materials that can be made with bonds that we can take apart so that we can enable disintegration in a controlled manner when we're ready. I have learned that in some cases, half of this cycle is possible. We can use, for example, solid carbon byproducts taken from the manufacture of aviation fuels, produced as a byproduct of the capture of flare gas and oil production, or produced as a byproduct of hydrogen for hydrogen vehicles. Those solid carbon products can be particles or fibers, typically at the nanoscale, added to the cement binder. They enable us to engineer the cracking and failure of the concrete. I've also learned that in some cases, we come closer to achieving the full cycle of creating materials we can build with, which will eventually disintegrate. One example is we can use photosynthetic bacteria to provide an alternative bio-based binder for material like concrete. This material can achieve the compressive strengths required for construction, but it can also be engineered to disintegrate under controlled conditions. Today, we have the capability to make new, lower carbon construction materials that can satisfy the criteria for strength for construction. These materials, though, can also disintegrate. This makes me very happy, because thinking back to those adobe walls, I recognize that structures built with these materials will require more care. They will require repair. But I also know that we can recover all the natural resources that we put into them. Now, my colleague, Professor Jeff Cameron, has taken home the ingredients for bio-based concrete. He's allowed his children to mix those in the kitchen, and they can form bricks with them. My daughter is in kindergarten. She proudly shows off her piece of bio-based materials to her friends. These are the types of materials we want our children building with in the future. Thank you.